वाय वंदना योजना, दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. द पर्पस इज सोशल सिक्योरिटी ड्यूरिंग ओल्ड एज. सो दिस इज समथिंग न्यू बिकॉज टिल नाउ और सिंस 1991 द पेंशन और द इंश्योरेंस लेट्स से यू नो पेंशन स्कीम्स दैट वी हैड स्टार्टेड विद वर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन बेस्ड rather than defined benefit based. So before 1991, when the public sector companies were basically dominating in this sector, all the pension schemes and other social security schemes used to be defined benefit based, wherein a defined benefit was provided. Let's say you contribute for the next 40 years. After that, till your life ends, till you die, you will be getting 1000 per month. That is a defined benefit. But now it is contribution based because your money is being invested in the capital markets. Before, the money used to be kept by the government and invested by the government for social welfare. But now that money is going to the capital markets. Okay. So now with that contribution scheme, contribution based pension schemes, this is something new. So the government is going back to this defined benefit, especially for old people. So what they're doing is, elderly people who are aged 60 and above can actually invest in this and they will be getting certain defined benefit. The scheme enables old age income security for senior citizens through provision of assured pension or return linked to subscription amount based on government guarantee to LIC. So what you are going to do, what the government is going to do is, this is an individual. This individual will invest in Vaya Vandana Yojana through LIC. LIC is going to provide certain interest or specific return to this individual, let's say 8%. Okay, this is the government. The government says, the LIC says to the government, I am providing 8% to this individual, but I am getting only 6% return on this. Okay, so now the government is going to fill this gap and provide the remaining 2% to LIC, so that LIC, being a public sector company, does not miss out or does not lose out money, does not go into losses, and at the same time the individuals are also secured, especially the old people above 60 years of age. Okay, an assured return of 8% per annum for 10 years will be provided under this scheme. Okay, so this is mentioned here, the differential return, difference between return generated by LIC and assured return of 8% per annum will be borne by Government of India as subsidy on an annual basis. Okay, now the minimum purchase price and all these figures are also provided, and they are very important. They can actually be asked in the exam. Minimum purchase price 1,50,000 for a minimum pension of 1,000 per month. Maximum is 7,50,000 for a maximum pension of 5,000 per month. The reason for decline in growth in India has provided lower growth in agriculture and allied sector, mining and quarrying and manufacturing. So basically, out of these three sectors that we have, it is only the services sector that is still performing better, well. Manufacturing, even after Make in India, and agriculture, even after so many schemes, is actually not doing very well. These two sectors are still falling behind because of various reasons. It is only the services sector which is still pulling up Indian economy. So the latest growth numbers of all these three, and also the contribution of employment of all these three, and the GDP growth numbers for the latest quarter, Jan to March, and also the yearly GDP numbers given by various international organizations and also by Indian organizations, Indian like CSO, like RBI, those are important. I have discussed those numbers specifically in, I believe, 5th or 6th May's current affairs. I also created a video on the same thing, I think almost 2 months back, but I have recreated that video through daily current affairs. So if you don't remember those numbers, or if you don't know those numbers, I have compiled them for you, and they are available in the PDFs also, so you can use them. And that is something that is very important. I just remember that. Okay. Number of enrollments in PMSBY increased to 8.85 crore. So that is increased to 13.41 crore. Okay. So that is all that is important here. That is what I wanted to mention. Business Expectations Survey, a new survey by National Council for Applied Economic Research, NCAER. This confidence index has gone down by 2.5%. This is not important. What is important is the components of business confidence index. There are four components. Out of these, three have gone down. Only one has gone up. The three which have gone down are present investment climate. So what you need to remember is, what are these components? Present investment climate, overall economic conditions in the next 6 months, financial position of firms in the next 6 months. And the component which has showed an improvement is present capacity utilization close to or above optimal level. So this is where this component has shown an improvement. All three components, other components, have shown a decline. So what you need to remember here is these four components that are there, the name of these four components under business confidence index. India's contribution to GDP increased to 3.1% from 3% and almost 2.8% in 2015. So India's share in total world GDP in percentage terms, okay, that is important here. Government of India and Asian Development Bank have signed an 80 million loan agreement to help boost youth employability in the state of Himachal Pradesh. So the state is important. How much, what is the amount of loan agreement, that is important. What they are going to do, they are going to modernize the vocational education and training institutions. The state will need more than 5 lakh skilled workers by the end of 2022 across various trades. So keeping that in mind, Asian Development Bank has provided this loan to India in order to boost employability through vocational training.